Hasudungan biology and medicine videos. Please make sure to subscribe, join the forum and group for the latest videos. Please visit Facebook at Hasudungan. Please like, and here you can also ask questions, answer questions, and post some interesting things, including your artworks. You can also change the quality settings to the highest one for better graphics. In this video, we'll look at the mucosal immune system of the gut, so the intestinal tract. Before continuing on, if you haven't watched the overview of the mucosal immune system, I suggest you watch that first before watching this. So we begin by learning about the mucosal immune system of the gut by firstly learning about the mesenteric lymph nodes. Mesenteric lymph nodes are like any other lymph nodes in that they contain arteries and veins coming out of them, and they also have lymph vessels coming in and out of them, which connects to the surrounding intestinal tissues, the submucosas. Mesenteric lymph nodes are important to initiate an immune response, particularly an adaptive immune response. Mesenteric lymph nodes, like the normal lymph nodes, contain lymphocytes, naive lymphocytes, or inactivated lymphocytes. They contain naive CD8 and CD4 T cells. There are areas in the lymph node known as follicles where naive B cells reside. These naive B cells typically express IgM and sometimes IgD antibodies. The mesenteric lymph nodes connect with areas around the gastrointestinal tract. Here we have the lymph vessel connecting to regions around the body, especially to regions below the mucosal surface of the gut, because we are talking about the gut mucosal immune system. These are the mucosal surface cells, the epithelial cells, and they form crypts, and they also contain villi, which are important for food absorption. Therefore, this area up here is known as the intestinal lumen, because the lumen is where the food passes through, as well as where the bacteria is present. Now, there are regions all around the gut tract, especially in the small intestines, known as the Peyer's patches. Peyer's patches are lymphoid tissues, and therefore they contain immune cells. Peyer's patches are important in protecting the body from invasion and initiating an immune response. Another important area is known as the lamina propria, which is also below the mucosal surface. Lamina propria is basically connective tissue which has many types of immune cells, particularly the activated immune cells such as the CD8 and CD4 T cells. Now let's talk about Peyer's patches in a bit more detail. Peyer's patches contain special cells, epithelial cells, on the mucosal surface, known as follicle-associated epithelial cells. Within this area, we also have other special cells known as microphage cells, or M cells. M cells are important in antigen sampling, in taking in antigens to initiate an immune response. Peyer's patches also contain follicles, where B cells predominantly reside in, as well as T cells in the surrounding area. Dendritic cells are also found here because dendritic cells are important in initiating or activating the adaptive immune response. We'll learn about the Peyer's patches more later on. Now let's talk about the lamina propria. Lamina propria, as I mentioned, is our connective tissue, and they contain a vast array of actually activated immune cells. The lymph vessels also connect to the lamina propria, where the immune cells can go in and out of. The lamina propria contains macrophages, phagocytes, and also activated CD8 and CD4 T cells, or T killer or T helper cells. They also contain plasma cells, which are the activated B cells. And therefore, the lamina propria is very important in essentially preventing infection beforehand. Now, the question is, where do these immune cells come from, particularly these naive immune cells, such as the naive lymphocytes? Well, they come from the high endothelial venules, from the bloodstream. From the thymus, the bone marrow, the naive lymphocytes actually circulate around the body, and they're not predetermined to go to the gut. They can go anywhere depending on where the signal takes them. For example, all lymphoid tissues secrete chemokines which attracts the lymphocytes. Now, the receptors CCR7 and L-selectin of the lymphocytes are attracted to chemokines CCL21 and CCL19, which are secreted by lymphoid tissues, including the Peyer's patches, but also the chemokines can be secreted by other lymphoid tissues such as the spleen and the lymph nodes. So these lymphocytes can literally go anywhere where these chemokines are being secreted from. So here we have a lymphocyte in the high endothelial venules with L-selectin, and the CCR7 receptor, which is attracted to the CCL21 and CCL19 chemokines coming from the Peyer's patches. The lymphocytes will enter the Peyer's patches. If it's a naive T cell, it will stay within the outside of the follicle. And if it was a naive B cell, it would be within the follicle. Now, if no antigen is present within the Peyer's patches, or there's no antigen to be presented to the lymphocyte by the dendritic cells, the lymphocytes will recirculate through the bloodstream because they still have these CCR7 and L-selectin receptors. So they will recirculate to other lymphoid tissues, such as the lymph nodes or the spleen. So what happens if an antigen is present? What happens to these lymphocytes? And how does an antigen get presented to these lymphocytes? Well, the M cells play a critical role here. The M cells take up the antigen, the process known as antigen sampling, and they transport it across to dendritic cells, where the dendritic cells can then present it to the lymphocytes. So how does this process occur? How does the M cell take up the antigen and essentially tell the dendritic cell that there is an antigen? And where's the communication between the M cell and the dendritic cell? Well, if here we have the associated follicle epithelial cells and here we have the M cell, here we have the intestinal lumen where the food passes through and where the pathogens are, the antigens of the pathogens, and here are the Peyer's patches where all the immune cells reside in, well, some of them. So the antigen and pathogen, if the antigen pathogen is present, the cells, particularly the follicle-associated epithelial cells, will begin secreting chemokines, CCL20 and CCL19. And remember, these are the chemokines that attract the lymphocytes, but they also attract dendritic cells. They attract the dendritic cells with the receptors CCR6 and CCR1. So now the dendritic cells knows that an antigen is present and that the M cell is about to take it up. The M cell takes it up through phagocytosis, or also known as endocytosis, and the process where it transported from the lumen to the Peyer's patches is known as transcytosis, trans as in a cross. So it transports this molecule, the antigen, from the lumen to the Peyer's patches where it will just excrete it out, and now the dendritic cells, which are there, can engulf it and present it on the major histocompatibility complex and present it to the adaptive immune cells. Now let's look at the bigger picture. Because the antigen is present now, because the M cell has already taken it up and brought it into the Peyer's patch, the lymphocytes will lose the receptors L-selectin and the CCR7. And now, and therefore, it cannot leave the Peyer's patches per se. So this dendritic cell with the antigen will now activate this naive T cell. And it can be a naive CD8 or naive CD4 T cell. The dendritic cells also uses retinol and converts it to retionic acid in the process to activate the T cells. Why does it do this? It does this in order for the T cells to begin expressing new receptors. These new receptors are known as homing receptors, which will tell where the lymphocytes have to go next. Now, if this activated T cell were a CD4 cell, it would become an activated T helper cell, which can then activate naive B cells within the follicles. The naive B cells, as I mentioned earlier, only express typically IgM antibodies and sometimes IgD antibodies. But once activated, particularly in the mucosal immune system, they begin expressing IgA antibodies. IgA antibodies is important for the mucosal immune system because IgA antibodies are the antibodies which prevent infection. The activated CD8, the activated CD4, and the activated B cell will then leave the Peyer's patches and travel through the body via the lymph vessel. They will travel around the body and typically end up in the lamina propria, if you remember the other area of the beneath the mucosal surface. So after the antigen-presenting cells interacts with the lymphocytes begin expressing the homing receptors. Remember, the homing receptors, which will direct them to the lamina propria. Homing receptors are induced by the retinoic acid and by dendritic cells. So remember, the lymphocytes lost their initial receptors, CCR7 and L-selectin, which brought them to lymphoid tissues. And once these lymphocytes were activated, they begin expressing homing receptors here, these homing receptors, which will allow them to leave the Peyer's patches through the lymphatic vessel and head to the mesenteric lymph nodes, and then following that to the lamina propria or other areas around the body. So here the activated CD8 and the activated CD4 cells are in the mesenteric lymph nodes now after traveling from the Peyer's patches, as well as the activated B cell.